Hello, loves. Hello, my ho people, my ho squad and nation. It is time for another underrated. This time we're going in with honey. That's right, that sweet, syrupy honey. My honey is a little sexy. We're going with sexy honey because why not? I like deep, rich, sweet honeys. It is that time of year, it's fall, so those are the honeys I gravitate toward. Now let's get into the honey, the underrated honeys that I'm coming with this time around. You know, for me, doing video sometimes is like taking that moment because, you know, I live intergenerational. And so it's Saturday afternoon. So I have to take that moment when it is kind of quiet in the household. Because if I don't, honey, y'all know y'all little favorite people, my tiny terrors, take over and are like, come on, Gigi, let's do this. They have plans for me. So now the house is quiet. They are taking naps. So I said, let me just do some fragrance. Let's do a video. So let's do this video and talk honey. All right. So let's talk about honey a little bit. I'm trying to like, you know, come with some information too. All right. So honey has been used in perfumery for over 15,000 years in ancient air perfumers, being the first to capture its sweetness. Of course, today it's usually used as a synthetic note. Using aromatic chemicals to create that scent. They can also use natural alternatives like honeysuckle that will give it a light floral scent. It's a sweet, of course we know honey has a distinctive smell. All you have to do is grab a bottle of honey to know what honey smells like. It can add depth, it can add warmth and a richness to a fragrance. It can also give what people say an animalic smell to it and an amber floral. It can give it a amber. It can pull out florals. It can do, add a sweetness to it, of course, pull out some, play with the florals with it. It's often used in spicy accords with cinnamon or in leather, and it helps with leather accords for those dense fragrances. Of course, honey can be very thick, bring a thickness to a sweet thickness to a fragrance. And it can be used to emphasize floral notes. There's different types of honeys, of course. Orange blossom honeys, eucalyptus honeys. I am a honey person. I love the scent of honey in fragrances. A lot of people don't. They say it goes animalic. I don't get that from it. I love the way it smells. There are many different vibes of honey in fragrances. I'm going to give you six as an honorable mention, because from now on I'm going to go with top five on these underrateds for a reason. For one thing, I was getting carried away with putting out too many in these underrateds, which would then mean that I didn't have enough to do another one. And also y'all was getting a lot for a giveaway, which meant that I didn't have enough to do another one. And so I've decided that I'm going to do five in each of these, and maybe a honorable mention, maybe six. That way it forces me to just stay with that number and not be trying to give y'all way too many. So what I've done is I've gone with my winter honeys. I do have some honeys that are more suited for spring and summer. These are my rich, deep, deep honeys. So we're going to start with, now these are some real good ones. And once again, interestingly enough, really don't get a lot of love. Y'all, they barely get any love in the female frag com. Barely any love in female frag com. Let me just say it like that. Barely any love in female frag com. Y'all don't be. Okay, so we're going to start here. We're going to start with This one. This is Scandal Gold. Now, Scandal, of course, is a well-loved franchise in Jean-Paul Gaultier, but this is Scandal Gold. This was actually made for the Middle Eastern market, and they finally brought it over to the other markets. Now, this one has that Scandal DNA, which is a very sexy DNA, but it has this is a little more spicy because they do have honey in them, but this one is a little more spicy. It has cardamom, it has saffron in it, but it also, what it has leather, it has patchouli in it. This one is, the other ones are a little more flirty, sexy. You know, this one, this one is a darker, deeper, more dramatic sexy. So Scandal Gold is giving a little more dramatic sexy when it comes down to it. And the honey is a little richer. Like Scandal at night is gorgeous and it has a little honey tones in it. But this one is a little more heavier on the honey tones. And it's a little more dramatic. It is a very dramatic. It is like a opera diva dramatic when it comes down to it, if you're talking about the Scandals. So this is Scandal Gold by Jean-Paul Gaultier. All right, next up is Kiss My Name by Ramon Monegal. Now, I know everybody goes on to Fragrantica, and you're going to go on there and look in there and say, but Lou, ain't no honey listed. Okay, I'm going to need y'all to go and actually go onto Ramon Monegal's website, because when I smelled this, I was like, this is honeyed. And yes, this is a honeyed white floral. This is a beautiful, gorgeous white floral. This is a very strong powerhouse of a white floral with this drizzle of honey running through it. I wore this in the summertime too, but really this is kind of like an all-around white floral, because it is a very strong, it is a in your face white floral. It is really for somebody who really loves a good white floral, specifically tuberose. It is very tuberose driven, and it's got this punch of honey in it, and the honey is saying hello. And if you love a honeyed floral, especially a honeyed white floral, you really want to try Ramon Monegal's Kiss My Name. It is sexy. It is gorgeous. It is beautiful. Now, next up is this one. Hard to Come By. I know I'll be messing with y'all, but that's why I do the giveaways. And speaking of the giveaways, let's just talk about the giveaway right now. Yes, there is the underrated giveaway. And as always, let's just say you have to comment. You have to subscribe. You have to comment. Tell me, if you have a favorite honey fragrance, put it in the comments and make sure you put a bee in your comment. And if you don't have a honey fragrance, tell me something you like about honeys. Do you have a favorite, a honey that you love, or are you sweet like honey? Just tell me some honey like. All right. So next up is this. This is Oud Ambrosie. Hard to Come By. I haven't seen this one come up on the gray market in a minute. This is, I wonder if they're doing this one in the new Lancome Rose line. This is Honey and Rose and Oud. This is part of the Maison Lancome line. So think Oud Bouquet, but this is, as opposed to Praline, this is honey and this is stunning. And let me tell you who made me get this. Joss Jane. My girl Joss, because she loves this and she talked about this all the time. And I actually tried this with Rose, Dr. Rose. She sent me some of this a long time ago. I wasn't ready for it because I really wasn't ready for honey at that point, right? True story. Rose sent me some of this and I wasn't quite ready for honey. And then here we go with the next part of the story. JC from Ganache sent me Stung and I fell in love with honey. And then Jazz kept talking about Udambrosi, and it was out of stock for a long time. By then it was out of stock. I was like, dang, I should have bought it. And it came back in stock and I snatched it, and I was so glad I got it, because this is a beautiful rose oud, but it is honeyed. It is a honeyed rose oud with a little patchouli and a little cedar. OMG, this is gorgeous. This is so beautiful, but it is rich in honey. So it you have to love honey to love this. So this is Oud Ambrosi by Maison Lancôme. Another stunning, stunning, stunning rose oud honey combination. Next up is this one. And I can promise you, I've looked around, I don't know, maybe one of has talked about this one. And this is Jewelry by Kajal. Y'all love Lamar. I don't get it. I don't get it. Okay. Everybody love Kajal, just a little too masculine for me. But Jewelry right here, she's a whole vibe. She's a whole vibe. This is now. You see, it looks like a rose on top. That's exactly what it is. It is this incredibly honey, spicy floral. Really kind of rose driven. It's got orange blossom and ylang-ylang, but it's really rose. But it is just, you get this spiciness. You get the ginger and the cloves and the nutmeg. I love cloves. It's cloves and ginger. You really get that in the beginning, and then you get the rose and you get honey, baby, and it's got vanilla and tonka bean. This smells so intensely. This is holidays, baby. This is holidays. I will be talking about this in the holidays, smelling like holiday desserts, because I have my holiday fragrances too. But this is like, this smells so good. This smells like you are just like a holiday. This is cozy. This is sweater weather. This is just really a comfy cozy, but it's really heavily on the honey. It's very spicy rose with that honey and vanilla, and you just have to give it a try. Once again, this is Jewelry by Kajal. Okay, so now this next one, ain't a lot going on. There's not a lot going on this one, but it is an intense fragrance. This is Fils de Joie by Serge Lutton. Look at how deep and dark and beautiful red that is. This is just a few notes. Now, let me tell y'all, this is not for everybody. This is jasmine. This is honey. This is ylang-ylang and musk. This is not for everybody, and this is not for every occasion. You really have to be able to wear this. This is, when they say gothic and dark fragrances, this should be like right there. This is dark, like when they say indolic, and when they say indolic, I looked this up too. Indolic can have an animalic. It can be very sensual. It can be very like, you know, it could just take your breath away, right? Jasmine is known for that. This has night blooming jasmine and jasmine in it. Ylang-ylang, honey is known for that. This is a very rich fragrance. It's as rich and deep as this red is. The musk is there, and it's just, it's trying. It's fighting with these. And it's saying, come on, let me just calm y'all down. And it's there to calm down these really intense fragrances notes in here. But this is very intense. This is real talk. This is date night. This is late night. This is a fragrance that's truly, truly, truly for a sensual sexual encounter. This is not for play. You did not come to play when you're wearing this. You honestly did not come to play. You know what your intentions are. Don't be playing around trying to act innocent when you're wearing something like this, because this says seductive all day, every day, anytime you're wearing this. This is Fils de Joie by Serge Lutton. Okay, so this last one is my newest one into my collection. This is by Trussardi. This is part of the La Vie Milano de Milano, which is the streets of Milan. And this is, I'm going to leave it up here, the courtyards of Castello something, something, right? This has a lot of notes. Y'all see, I've been putting up the notes. See, I'm trying to get better. And this is intense, but let me tell you, the, as you can see, it has a lot going on. It's got the saffron and that incense, because the olibanum is frankincense. The honey, it is, I wore it the other day. I did wear it. And it is so beautiful on. The rose is so pretty. And then you get this honey on it. And there's these spices, but the spices are kind of sweet. The saffron, the pink pepper and everything, there's this sweetness to it with this smokiness. It's this sweet, spicy, smokiness to it. So it's like the honey gives it this sweetness, right? So you get this sweet, spicy, smoky, rosiness. You really have to try it, but it is so intensely gorgeous. I smelled so beautiful to me. And it was this beautiful, yet I want to say kind of, it's definitely dark and mysterious, but not too dark and mysterious. You know how some things are just really dark, like Fils de Joie is super dark. This just gives a little mystery, but not too much. This is like Fils de Joie is scary mystery, right? Courtyards is like pretty mystery. This is the kind of mystery that Fils de Joie gives scary mystery. This gives interesting mystery, like somebody wants to find out what your like head turning mystery, like, oh, you will want to follow that person and see what they're doing or things like that. So that's the difference with Fils de Joie, with the courtyards. It's like this intoxicating mystery that draws people in, whereas Fils de Joie can be scary and make people go like, this would be like something like Wednesday or in a scary movie. This would be like the seductress in the scary movie would wear. This one would be the one with where she would be turning you on, and like succubus sort of, this is what she would wear, because it would be like you would be drawn to this person because it's a really gorgeous scent. It's like, it's just really this beautiful rosy tone with this sweetness yet spicy. It is just beautiful. It is intoxicatingly gorgeous. And gives you this very, when I was wearing it, I just felt like I was just like extra sexy, but not too much. It was like this internal sexy that I was feeling. I didn't feel like I was doing too much where I was being, it was just enough. Like it would be like a mystery sexy, like it would turn heads, but not so much that it would be like overt. It was like, it would be like almost like a, I don't know how to explain it, but it's just, you just have to try it and just understand it to understand what I'm talking about. But anyway, this is the courtyards of Castello, however you say it. It's beautiful. It's gorgeous. Yes. So anyway, as I wear my braids, and it's Saturday afternoon, and I'm going to go out and now rake leaves, and let's just have a minute for the leaves. If you are a person, I'm using leaves. Leaves are good for the environment. Let me just say that. So if you have a yard with garden flowers, don't take the leaves and just throw them away. Use them in your yard. They're beneficial for the insects for the next season. So, and if you don't need them, maybe somebody around you has a yard or a garden. If you know somebody has a garden, bag them up and give them to them, because they're really good for your yard. You can mulch them, you can compost them. They're really good for those type of things. So just think about, as opposed to like throwing them away like we've been conditioned to do so much, let's try to be more intentional about the earth. Because I'm trying to be. And so just a little thought, as opposed to just, you know, bagging up the leaves and, you know, throwing them away. if there's a composting initiative in your area, you can donate them to that. You can, if you know, give them to any like community gardens because they can use them. You can even just, if you know people who garden, they will appreciate them because you can use them to mulch and use them for next season. Because I can bag, you know, the ones that I don't use now, I will be bagging them up and using them in the early spring. All right, so that's it for now. Thank you much, so much, my whole squad and whole nation. And don't forget, please feel free to join the whole nation and help support this channel. If you have an iPhone and can't see the join button, please just go ahead and get on a laptop and hit the join button. And then you can see everything on your phone. I keep trying to tell y'all that. So if you would like to join the whole nation. Oh, and the declutter is coming soon. I'm pulling things. It's about to be the most epic declutter you all have seen in a while. It's a lot of niche coming. I'm getting rid of a lot of stuff. Man, Sarah and niche. I'm just letting y'all know. I'm coming hard this time. I'm clearing these shelves because I got a lot of stuff, y'all. And I'm really about to be a really an intentional shopper, sort of, maybe. All right, y'all. Be bold, be brave, be fearless, be free. Talk to you later.